Checking document accessibility. Quick tips for PDFs.
An NCRTM videocast developed by New Editions Consulting, Inc.
This video is how to check your PDF for accessibility. A common type of document is a PDF. There are several simple checks you can do with Adobe Acrobat DC. Adobe Reader will not work to check if your PDF is accessible. This demonstration is using Adobe Acrobat DC. As a reminder, using built-in Microsoft Office templates, styling and formatting like lists, tables, and headings help ensure a fairly accessible document when it's converted to a PDF. Adobe Acrobat DC's built-in accessibility full check is the easiest and fastest tool to give you an overview of possible problems in your document. To run the accessibility checker, save your PDF, open Tools, scroll down and find Accessibility. It's usually at the bottom, and then run Full Check. The default values that are selected will suffice. The Accessibility Checker lists exactly where each issue occurs and when each line item is selected, you have the option to have the error explained. Show where the error is in the tags or content panel, and sometimes Adobe offers a fix option to very easily remediate the failure. Remediation will be covered in a subsequent video. We have adapted the following information from a group of accessibility experts within the government. We're going to run through 5 important and easy items to check within your PDF. The first one is if your PDF has tags. The second is if the tags in reading order are correct. Third is that your images are correct. The fourth one, checking that your tables have proper order and structure. And 5, and lastly, checking that your forms are programmatically associated. First, we'll talk about tags. Your first check will be, does the PDF have tags? Tags pass along programmatic information to assistive technology are an essential to an accessible PDF. The accessibility checker will show a failure under document tag PDF failed if there are no tags available. In this example, the accessibility checker does not return a failure. You can also quickly and manually check by going to File, Properties, and then the Description tag. At the very bottom, you'll see tagged PDF Yes. Alternatively, you can open up the Tags panel and verify there are tags within. We will go over the Tags panel next. Tags and reading order is your second check. As mentioned, tags provide critical information to assistive technology users. Tags should be correct and in the correct order so that assistive technology will read out the content in a logical reading order. If the reading order is not correct, the information may be confusing for a user. The accessibility checker will show a number of failures regarding tags that may not be correct, but it is important to go through each tag within the Tags panel. To check each tag, enable the Tags panel. I already have it here. But if it isn't on your computer, you can go to View, Show Hide, Navigation Panes, and Enable Tags. What it will do is enable this entire sidebar. Tags is at the very bottom. Once the Tags pane is opened, you can use the Shift and plus sign or the right arrow to show all tags. Mine has been enabled. And then mouse or arrow through the tags. And you'll see as you go through them, there's some tag jargon and it'll also show highlighting on the screen so you know exactly what you're looking at. Here, there's a heading that's highlighted. It matches the H1 tag. Below it is a P, which is a paragraph tag, and you see that on screen it is highlighting text in a paragraph. Once you have the Tags panel opened, you should check that, one, the tag is correct for the type of element. This includes headings, like the H1, and lists, like directions and how to make a pie crust. And, two, that the order of tags follows the visual or logical order, as this will be the order that the document is read in for assistive technology users. There may be some decorative items such as lines, like I have at the very top here, Banners, repeat, headers, and footers, anything that is redundant or not meaningful should be tagged as an artifact or background. This alerts assistive technology users that this isn't important and it should be ignored. As such, these tags will not show up in the tags panel, which is perfect. The decorative line at the top of the page is appropriately left out of the tags panel. In this example, as I arrow through, all the elements have an appropriate tag type, and the tag order follows the visual content. We'll do a quick little run through here. But you see, as I go through the tags, it highlights everything on the page in order that visually I would get it to. Tags are also a little complicated. Don't feel overwhelmed if you aren't sure, is an H2 what I should be looking at? There's more information you can find in online resources to help you understand what a tag should be and if a tag's correct. The third thing to check are images. Much like in the Word document check for accessibility, each image should have a descriptive alternative text associated with it so that users who cannot see the image understand the information it is conveying. The accessibility checker will alert you to any alternative text issues. Pay attention to anything that says figures alternative text failed, as this means images do not have any text with the alternative text property. While the checker will alert you, much like Word, to any empty alternative text, you should also double check all images to ensure that the alternative text is an accurate description of its purpose or function. You can easily double check the alternative text several ways, and some of this is up to user preference. The two easiest are selecting the tag in the tags panel, then right-click and open properties. The text will appear in the alternative text box if there is alternative text on the image. The second option is simply hovering over the figure within the PDF. And the alternative text, as you can see, will appear on screen upon hover. If nothing appears upon hover, the alternative text is probably empty. The fourth thing to check are tables. These can get a little complicated. We're going to keep it real simple here. Tables must have a proper table tag, which this one does, and table header and data cells must be properly tagged. First, check that all tables have a table tag. This can easily be done while reviewing the tags pane. In this example, as you can see, there is a correct table tag. Table cells also need to have proper programmatic association. The accessibility checker will alert you if there are no headers for a table showing a failure, tables, headers, failed. This, however, does not mean headers and data cells are correctly tagged. To check that table header cells have a TH to signify a table header tag, and data cells have a TD tag to signal table data cells, you'll need to select the table, right-click, and open Table Editor. I'm going to open my accessibility pane, select Reading Order. I'm going to select the table, right-click, and open my Table Editor. The table should be broken up into little cells. The standard color scheme to visibly show the table markup is that the table headers are highlighted in red, which you can see here, and table data cells have no highlighting or they're in a dull gray. Selecting a table cell, right-clicking and opening table cell properties will provide you a way to check and modify if your cell isn't labeled correctly. Here, I've opened a data cell. I see that it is a data cell, but if for some reason I wanted to change it to a header cell, I simply click on it and select OK. There are more advanced methods to checking tables, especially complex tables. Please refer to other resources in the YouTube description for where to find advanced information, because they can get fairly complicated. The fifth item to check are forms. Each form field must have a tooltip that matches all labels and instructions, and the tab order must match the visual or logical order of the form fields. The accessibility checker will display forms, field descriptions failed, as in this example. Let's run that full check again. Take a look at our failure. And you'll see here it has noted there's a field descriptions failure for forms. If I select field one, it will take me exactly to where this failure is, which I believe is on the address. Even if you get a forms description failed note on the accessibility checker or you don't see anything, you should still double check that each forms tooltip is accurate, since this is what a screen reader will access. For more information on how a screen reader accesses information within documents, see the video screen reader simulation on the NCRTM resources page. To check tooltips, open the Prepare Forms tab. Then select your form field, right click, and open Properties. The first three form fields have an accurate tooltip, but the last one doesn't. Here you see that this tooltip has name, asterisk, and a required field. The second one has the same in terms of asterisk, date of birth, noting it's a required form field. Email has a tooltip that matches the name of email. And the last one, address, has no tooltip, which is what triggered our failure over here in the accessibility checker. The last check we do for forms is to make sure that the tab order is correct. Tab order is important for interactive elements like form fields to make sure that the way a user interacts and receives information from the document is the same as the visual reading order. To check that the tab order matches the visual or logical order of the form fields, close your Prepare Forms tab, place your pointer focus above the form field somewhere on screen, and then use your tab button on your keyboard to tab through. Here you see that the tabbing order follows from top to bottom and is correct. These were five quick tips on how to check your PDF for accessibility. For more information or if you need any help, please feel free to contact the NCRTM support team at ncrtm@newadditions.net.